First of all, you're really lucky because I haven't seen that much pair of nipples in my life.
This is gonna be really awkward.
They were the reason I bought push-up bras because I wanted my boobs to look bigger. I have no makeup on and I'm basically wearing my pajamas. So let's do this. I've had a problem with my boobs since the moment I realized I was supposed to have them and I didn't. So let's rewind a little bit and just see, what are boobs even?
The breast is one of two prominences located on the upper ventral region of the torso of primates. In females, it serves as the mammary gland which produces and secretes milk to feed infants. Boobs are women's breasts. They secrete milk after pregnancy and tend to be very...
Let's just not go there. Put my son as a labor, it's how I want it. In a minute she
rose something that stink good, feeling haunted the way she goes and I make eye contact. Like, honestly, in the end of the day, what is more insignificant than the size of your boobs, like? Or the size of your thighs, or your legs, or your feet, or your freaking nose? Like, if you have a big nose, you can breathe better, right? So that shouldn't even be a problem.
My boyfriend has a big nose, and at least that's what he tells me.
I'm doing this video because when I was younger, I just know that I really needed these videos as a kid to feel better about something that I shouldn't even feel bad about. I feel like I probably have a few young girls watching my videos and some older girls that are just continue to struggle with this. So I'm doing it. Hey, I'm gonna read the caption of a photo that I posted on Instagram. So I posted this picture on Instagram that said, "Got a roll in my belly, double chin, and weird sized teeth. You probably hadn't noticed that. I would also not have noticed it if someone else wouldn't have made me notice it. Hey boomer, if you're still fighting to erase all of your flaws, I'm laughing at you."
Okay, lie, because I actually do the same. Just wanted to make that disclaimer right here, because we all do that, and I'm not laughing at you. I just want you to feel better. This is just my personal opinion and me trying to help you, even though I can't even help myself sometimes. So let's just go back to the video.
What you are running after is perfection, and that doesn't exist, because it's human nature to always find ways to better stuff or simply find its flaws. Be healthy, eat healthy, make exercise for your health. And then kiss your skin from head to toe. Love yourself so you can allow others to do the same. Respect your body, it is your home and not a temporary one. And hey, it's okay to eat that bag of Doritos. If my mom gave me more lunch money, I would probably eat one every day. I posted this picture because I knew no one was really gonna notice all of the flaws that I spoke about. And I did got a few DMs of people saying, if you didn't talk about it, I wouldn't have noticed this. And I responded that, yeah, because I also don't care about what you think is so horrible about your body.
That actually meant it, you are all beautiful in burp language, so respect it, please.
I titled this video, I don't have boobs, not because I don't have boobs. I actually now can see that my boobs aren't even that smaller, but for a lot of time, they were my biggest insecurity. They were the reason I didn't really want to go to the beach with my friend. They were the reason I bought push-up bras because I wanted my boobs to look bigger. And guess what? I still use freaking push-up bras. I'm using a push-up strapless bra right now. My 12-year-old, 13-year-old, 14-year-old self would have never let me say this on camera. I thought that I had less value as a person. I'm gonna insert here a clip of me and Mariana, which is a girl that also filmed the video with me previously, commenting and reacting to some insecurities that you, my subscribers, sent me on Instagram. So let's see what you're struggling with and make this a little bit more personal and interactive.
So just a little introduction on Mariana. When I think of her, I always like see her smiling. She's super kind, she's a science student, and mainly she just has a dog. A really cute one, like really cute one.
Okay, hey guys, hey guys, so as I just said, I'm here with Mariana on the phone and we're going to be reacting to your guys' insecurities and what you said that made you like self-conscious about your body. We both asked our followers and so we're just going to be reading it. We might give advice, but like our main focus is not like really giving advice because we don't really know anything. It's just like commenting on what you're saying and about the subjects. So, hi Mariana, you can speak on the other side.
I'm super shy right now.
You gotta go to the Instagram. Okay, first insecurity, having too much body hair. On this topic, like, I remember there was one time on 9th grade that I had, like, a boy that was, like, flirting with me, but then one day he told me that I had, like, a really big, like, mustache. And so that's, like, the only experience I've had with someone telling me I have, like, too much body hair, and that really made me, like, be super self-conscious. I do know that there are a lot of girls that just have a lot of body hair or it's really dark, and I don't know, what do you have to say?
Honestly, I love girls with body hair on their arms.
I have a friend that has like a lot of arm hair, and what she does is she lightens it. She doesn't like wax it, she just lightens it. And I don't really mind. I just feel like if you are comfortable with your body hair, then just rock it and own it, because it's something that's yours. And
sure.
Yeah, we're all so different that when we have things that are just really different from other people, we either like don't like them and we take them off, or we lighten the hair, or we just own it because it's ours and it's our body and we're... Yeah.
Imagine put so much work in something that's not even for us.
Yeah, exactly, because if you don't like aesthetically seeing it, then just take it off. But if it's just because of other people commenting but you don't really mind and you actually like, kind of like it, then just own it. And you can even joke about it, and then when people say that, when people like make fun of you, you're just like, yeah, I'm a werewolf, what do you have to say? You want me to bite you?
Wow.
Yeah, the other person said, and this is like basically one of my best followers, she's always commenting on my videos and DMing me, and I was really sad because she told me that she doesn't like her smile. She said, I don't like my smile, so I don't smile in pictures. One time a boy came up to me and he said I would go out with you, but only if you put braces. What do you have to say about this?
That's the most childish thing I've ever heard, honestly.
And nowadays, just everyone wears braces, and it's like
true.
Something so like deepened in our culture. But what I was saying to Mariana when we were talking about this before is that when you're smiling and you're like genuinely smiling and laughing and you're happy,
you look beautiful.
It's so special and it's so genuine and so pure beautiful that like I think they're ugly criers, but I don't think they're like ugly smilers.
I agree.
I've seen your Instagram, because as I said, you're like, you always DM me and I think I follow you, and your smile is just beautiful. Yeah, you don't have super perfect teeth, like braces teeth. I don't have braces either, so my teeth are not perfect. But when you have like photos when you're smiling, it's so pretty because it's so unique and it's so you. Like, I've never seen someone with that type of smile, and I like it, honestly.
You're so cute, Maya.
Then we have something here. I don't like my nipples. I think they're too big and I keep comparing myself to others. First of all, you're really lucky because I haven't seen that much pair of nipples in my life. So I can't compare myself with a lot of nipples.
No, like in school, after PE?
Not really. I mean, I was also always really shy and I would like take my shirt off super quickly because I didn't want anyone to see my boobs.
But still, all the girls walk around shirtless.
Yeah, I guess so. Because I had small boobs, I didn't even like think about nipples. I just thought about the boobs in general. So.
Honestly, if someone's going to see you naked, that's because they really like you.
Exactly.
And they won't even comment it.
Nipples are sexy, like just own it. I don't know what you want me to say. Like, nipples are meant to like breastfeed. So if you have bigger nipples, I'm trying to be logically.
Okay, girl, basically, don't think about it.
Yeah.
Nobody will know it.
I ran out of battery, so I'm only recording right now. Definitely not going to include like 40 minutes of me and Mariana speaking.
So I'm probably going to make a separate video where I include everything that we talked about. So if you want to check it out, let's give this video to 50 likes. I don't even know how many likes I normally get in my videos. But 50 likes and
I'm yeah, 100.
Think with okay.
You have to be more ambitious.
Okay, that's it.
Okay.
Thank you so much for helping me in this video.
It was my pleasure, Maya. Bye-bye.
Now that Mariana is here, let's just go to my ramble.
It's all a question of health. If you're healthy, if you're not fat or obese, you might have a little bit more fat in your belly or in your butt or in your toenails. But it doesn't matter. If you're gonna work out, take responsibility for it. I don't have a toned stomach, which means that if I'm like this, I'm gonna have a roll here. My boyfriend says I'm fat, but like, I'm pretty sure he's not talking seriously when he says that, right? And for a couple of years now, every summer, I get one of those 21-day ab challenges for my abs. And I do like 2 weeks, and then I give up because I don't see results. And I hate working my abs. I hate working out at home. It's freaking boring. So I'm not gonna make a 21 ab challenge this year. I'm gonna hike, I'm gonna run, but I'm not gonna put myself inside of my room. So either take responsibility, go work out and erase what you don't like, or just accept it, or else you're gonna spend your whole life hating on things that you know you won't even change because you just don't have the patience to, and it's okay. We spend so much time trying to do stuff that we never actually finished just so we can tell ourselves that we tried. So now, with this said, let's go into Maria, which is also one of my good YouTube frenzies.
Okay, Maria. When I think of Maria, I think of her artsy and painted room. I think of her super cool and different outfits. And I think of her goat because she freaking has a pet goat and it's the cutest thing ever.
Hi guys, so I'm here with Maria, just as I said.
Hi guys.
And we're going to take two BuzzQuid quizzes.
After this, Maria's camera stopped filming, so we had to answer the questions all again, so that's why it's a little bit speeded up. Let's just get into it.
Okay, we are filming now for the second time because we are dumb. And we're going to be taking some BuzzFeed quizzes about boobs. This is going to be really awkward, but basically the first one is, our McDonald's and Starbucks order will decide our boob size. So let's just go into it and see what will happen to our boobs.
Yeah, let's see if they write. Okay, let's start.
Okay, the first one, I had picked the juice.
I picked the tea because we spilled the tea all the way up. Okay, for breakfast.
The Egg McMuffin is disgusting. And we are vegetarian, so I'm gonna pick the hash brown. I love hash brown.
I will choose maple oatmeal, maybe. I think it. Pick a drink. I think the gram, yeah, maybe.
Yeah, I'm going with the tall. Then, burger from McDonald's. I was saying to Maria that I love ordering cheeseburgers with no meat at McDonald's, and the employees just get super frustrated.
I think I will choose a classic Angus because it seems like
more. Yeah, it looks good.
Yeah. The flavor, I still like not knowing which one because in summertime maybe the peppermint, but like.
Yeah, or the raspberry.
I love
but I really like vanilla.
Caramel. Yeah. Okay, the sauce.
Pink, pink. Honey mustard. Even though in Portugal they don't have like any sauces, they give you like ketchup and mayo. But I like
I only know the ketchup because I'm a basic bitch. Pick a type of milk to add to your Starbucks.
Soy.
Almond. Oh my god, almond. It's bad.
I feel like I'm just picking soy because if I go like from the logical, like almond and coconut oil are basically like water with flavor. But then soy has like protein, so we're all about that veggie protein.
Oh, I don't give a shit actually. I love the almond. Like, okay, something sweet from McDonald's. Oh my god, I love the baked apple pea.
Yeah,
that's good. But I also
the
love
sundae.
Ice cream. I love sundaes.
Oh my god, I already clicked and it already got me the results. Click.
Okay, you got an A. What?
I got a B.
They write because
yeah,
mine is actually smaller size, so
they actually got mine right. They said B,
and they are like that's something to be proud of. Oh, thank you so much. That makes me feel
like,
so much better.
They're like, you're blessed with boobs that are probably the same my hands, the same size as my hands. No, and how fun is that? They're seriously so fun to hold. Your boobies are beautiful and suit your body perfectly.
Oh my god, they Oh, they're so right. Like they said, who needs cleavage when you can feel comfortable and free without a bra? That's so
yes,
because I
true.
Never use a bra.
Yeah. Okay, so I filmed a lot more content with Maria and we took another quiz that's super awkward and has questions like this one.
Is it?
okay, we are getting there.
But I couldn't include everything in this video, so if you want me to post the rest of it, comment Saul down below.
If you want to look for flaws, you will always find flaws. It's not because you make a plastic surgery to make more boobs that you're not going to then focus on the fact that you have a roll in your belly. My dad always told me, if it's not broken, don't fix it. And in our society, we see too much broken in things that are completely okay.
Stop complaining about things that you can't change. But also stop complaining about things that you can change, but you know deep down that you won't change. You're just wasting your own time, and you know it. So this was this video, guys. I really want to start making more videos talking about these things. App talks, girl talks, TMI talks, something like that, where I speak more about this. It doesn't have to be an elaborate video like this one. So yeah, I really hope you liked this video, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye!